Now we'll describe how the CalEnviroScreen score is calculated for each census tract. The available data for each of the indicators come in a number of different formats. Some data sets are already available at the census tract scale, such as data from the Census Bureau. Other data sources don't provide census tract information, so the location-related information needs to be established with respect to the census tract. This type of information can include street addresses, facility locations, or site boundaries. Because the data sources for different indicators vary, unique methods were needed to analyze each one so that a level for each indicator for every census tract in the state could be established. Here, for example, a census tract in Sacramento is outlined in red. This color-coded map shows varying ozone concentrations across the Sacramento region. Lighter shades of blue indicate lower concentrations of ozone, while darker blue represents higher concentrations. In this case, the census tract was assigned an ozone concentration based on the levels across the region estimated by the Air Resources Board. Likewise, all other tracts in the state were also assigned ozone concentrations. As a result, we can characterize this outlined tract as being higher or lower in ozone when compared to other census tracts. We ranked census tracts across the state from highest to lowest based on their ozone concentrations. While other indicators use different data sources and require different types of analysis, this type of analysis showing comparative indicator scores was done for indicators for all census tracts in California when information was available. In the previous module, you learned about the different types of raw data that are available for the various indicators. Once we have collected these, we convert the raw values into a percentile score. For any given census tract, the percentile score shows us how the raw values for this census tract compare to those for other census tracts across the state. To begin, we start with the raw values. For example, we may have ozone concentrations, the number of cleanup sites, or asthma or poverty rates, to name a few. All of the census tracts are then ranked by the raw values for the indicators from lowest to highest. Each census tract is then assigned a percentile score between 0 and 100 based on where the raw value falls in comparison to all other tracts. For example, a 75th percentile means that a tract score is higher than 75% or 3/4 of all census tracts for that indicator. This is a common method of comparison. It's the same approach frequently used for standardized tests or growth charts for infants. Using percentiles allows a comparison of the census tracts across the state for each indicator and makes them easier to understand. This is an example of an exposure indicator, PM2.5. PM2.5 concentrations in the air across California range from about 2.3 to 17 micrograms per cubic meter. This table shows 11 example census tracts labeled A through K with a variety of PM2.5 values. To convert the values shown here into percentiles, the census tracts are ranked from lowest to highest. Then we calculate a percentile from the raw values. For CalEnviroScreen, we use a statistical program to do this since there are a large number of census tracts. Now you can see that the highest PM2.5 concentration gets a percentile of 100 and the lowest get 0.01, or the lowest possible percentile. The 50th percentile is identified as the census tract that has an equal number of other census tracts that are higher as there are census tracts that are lower. Now, let's take a look at scoring in more detail. After percentile values are calculated for each of the indicators, we can calculate the overall CalEnviroScreen score. First, the percentiles for the individual indicators and a component are averaged. The pollution burden score is calculated by combining the average of the 7 exposure indicators and the average of the 5 environmental effects indicators. The environmental effect component is half-weighted. This is because direct exposure to pollution, like breathing in contaminated air, is likely to contribute more to a person's total pollution burden than the impact of living near facilities or contaminated land or water. For simplicity, the average of the pollution burden percentiles is divided by 10 to put it on a 0 to 10 scale. The population characteristic score is calculated by combining the average of the 3 sensitive populations indicators and the average of the 5 socioeconomic factors indicators. Here, all the population characteristics indicators are weighted equally. Again, dividing by 10 produces scores ranging from 0 to 10. The overall CalEnviroScreen score is calculated by multiplying the pollution burden and population characteristic scores together. This decision to multiply was based on scientific principles and published research. The resulting CalEnviroScreen score, which ranges from 0 to 100, allows us to compare the combined impact score across all census tracts in the state. A higher score means that the census tract has greater overall pollution burdens and population vulnerability. Here is an example of how we calculate the CalEnviroScreen score for an example census tract. On the top right, we see information about this tract. It's located in the central west area of the city of Fresno. You can see the tract number, its population, and its location on the map. The CalEnviroScreen score for our example census tract in central west Fresno is 78.41, puts this census tract in the 96th to 100th percentile, meaning it is a place with high pollution burden and population vulnerability. Let's see how this number was calculated. On the screen are the percentiles for the exposures and environmental effects indicators. We can tell that this census tract has high pollution because the percentiles for PM2.5, ozone, and diesel PM emissions are each over 90. The average of the exposure percentiles and the average of the half-weighted environmental effects percentiles produce a pollution burden score of 8.41 out of a possible 10. On the screen are the sensitive population and socioeconomic factor indicator percentiles. This census tract has many indicators over the 90th percentile, including one of the highest poverty rates in the state with a percentile value of 100. Here, we take the average of the sensitive population percentiles with the average of the socioeconomic factor percentiles, which produce a population characteristic score of 9.32 out of a possible 10. The pollution burden score is multiplied by the population characteristic score for a CalEnviroScreen score of 78.41, one of the highest scores in the state. The CalEnviroScreen score for our example census tract in central west Fresno as labeled on this map of the area. This same calculation is performed on every census tract in the state in order to compare all communities to one another based on their relative pollution burden and vulnerability. Here are the outlines of the surrounding census tracts and their CalEnviroScreen scores. Some of the surrounding tracts have similar scores, while some are lower. As we said earlier, the overall CalEnviroScreen scores can also be converted into percentiles so that we can compare the census tracts to one another. Now you can see the CalEnviroScreen scores categorized by color based on percentile. Here, the darkest red represents the highest scoring tracts with percentiles between 90 and 100. Most of the census tracts surrounding our example tract score relatively highly, as indicated by the color. In the next module, we'll review the statewide results and give you some examples of how to interpret the information from CalEnviroScreen.